Jim and I had worked out a bunch of songs, and Rick and the Ravens, not a bunch, but enough, Rick and the Ravens were sort of the backup band for the Doors. Now, we kind of plugged John Densmore into that, and we're working on some songs with my two brothers and one of their bass player buddies, and just working out some songs together. And then that started to fall apart. And we had our three single. Rick and the Ravens had their three single thing. Rick and the Ravens were falling apart. And we said to Dick Bach, listen, can we, I'm putting a new band together here. It's called The Doors. Can we do a demo session? And he said, well, you know, I owe you one more record. And why don't you, instead of making that record, why don't you just go ahead, use the studio time and go ahead and make a demo? And I said, well, that'd be great. Thank you very much. Perfect. He said, because, you know, I'm not going to release the record. I mean, the band has fallen apart and everything. Okay, fine. That's fine. So we go into the recording studio. The bass player quits. You know, and it was like my two brothers were the last ones left. Densmore's playing drums. My brother Rick's playing guitar. My brother Jim's playing mouth harp. Real nice, real sweet mouth harp. Harmonica. We proceeded to play six songs, and among those songs were the very first song we played, Moonlight Drive, and A Little Game was on there, Hello, I Love You was on there, and Summer's Almost Gone, and one or two others. And that is our official Doors demo that we walked the streets with, unable to get a record deal from anybody with a demo. It didn't work out in the least, you know. So at the time, we're walking the streets with the demo. Rick and the Ravens have broken up, and my brothers have gone their separate ways, and that whole thing fell apart. You know, there we are, John, Ray, and Jim, and Dorothy, and we don't have a guitar player. So we walk the streets with this demo, and we're going from record company to record company, and I'm, of course, getting nowhere with it. You know, you don't just walk in off the street with an acetate, but we thought it was so good that someone would definitely pick up on it eventually. So we went to see somebody at Liberty Records, and I was there alone with this guy, and he had a hit song, had either produced or something, some kind of vaguely outer space, outer limits kind of song, something like that, had a pretty good instrument hit with it. So we went in to see him, and I thought, well, here's our music. Check this out. And he listened to a few of the cuts, and he said, I don't really like it. I said, well, wait. The last song, check the last one, because it's kind of like the song that you did, you know, that outer space thing. It's called A Little Game, because it starts with a tink, 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 and he starts listening to it, and it just goes tink, tink, tink. Once I had a little game, I like to crawl back in my brain. Tink, tink, tink. I think you know the game I mean. I mean the game called Go Insane. And the guy heard the word Go Insane with a tink. Then the band comes in, tinky, 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 tinky. And he said, this isn't anything like my outer space song. This is not. He said, this is sick. This is sick. This is ridiculous. Get out of here. Just get out of here. Don't you dare be comparing what you're doing to what I'm doing. And virtually threw me out of the office at Liberty Records. I said, okay. You don't have to get mad, man. I thought you might like it. It was a bunch of companies. We went to every company in Los Angeles. I mean, we walked into RCA. We walked into a Capitol. We walked into the Great Tower and all these gold records. And there's the four of us, man, in Hollywood from out of Venice. And we're in Hollywood. And we walk up to the front desk and say, hi, we're a rock and roll band. We're called The Doors. And, you know, I was going to put my arm around. This is Jim Morrison. He's going to be a legend someday. And we looked at the girl and said, do you have anybody that listens to demos? Who should we see? An A&R department? And the girl just looked up at us and said, we don't have anybody here for you guys to listen to. There's nobody that wants to listen to your music. We don't take unsolicited demos. Sorry. Have a nice day. And she put her head back down and went back to what, and we just looked at the gold records and went, oh.